Velkommen inn til Sjømannskirkens kontor. Dette er min pult, og her pleier jeg å sitte og jobbe til vanlig. Så jeg tenkte det passer fint å bringe dere også med inn her. Denne uken vi går inn i nå, kaller vi for den stille uken. Vi har vært gjennom fastetiden. I går feiret vi Palmesøndag, og nå begynner den stille uken. På engelsk så kaller vi faktisk denne uken for The Holy Week, mens den på tysk kalles for Karwoche, sørgeuken, den stille uke. De viktigste dagene denne uken er skjærtorsdag, langfredag og påskeaften. I den katolske tradisjonen så kalles disse dagene for Triduum Paschale. Og det kan oversettes til de tre påskedager. Disse påskedagene markeres jo også i den lutherske kirken, så her i Sjømannskirken så vil vi ha både skjærtorsdagsmesse, langfredag og vi vil feire påskeaften sammen på Facebook. I folketradisjonen så pleide den stille uke å bli skildret som en sørgehøytid. Og derfor så brukte en ikke så mye musikk, en brukte også å dempe klokkene. Og derav kommer altså da navnet Den stille uke. Så når de ringte i kirkeklokkene, så pleide de å dekke klokken til med tøy, sånn at du skulle få en dempet lydeffekt. Så dette er altså Den stille uke. Men jeg har jo vært litt nysgjerrig på påsketradisjoner rundt omkring i verden. Og jeg har vært også litt nysgjerrig på hvordan de feirer påsken her i England. Så jeg har da sendt meg selv ut på gata for å prate med litt forskjellige folk. Jeg vil på forhånd bare beklage formatet. Det ble ikke helt som jeg hadde tenkt. Men her er altså Ingeborg ute på tur for å finne litt ut av hva en gjør i påsken. Jeg befinner meg i London, her jeg har vært en god stund nå. Jeg tenkte jeg skulle oppsøke litt briter for å høre litt hva de egentlig gjør i påsken, for det lurer jeg på. Fordi vi er nordmenn. Vi er ganske gode på å feire påske.
Sorry, can I? No, you're talking the phone. That's fine. Can I ask?
That's okay.
That's fine. Min største drøm er egentlig å bli journalist, skjønner du? NRK, vårt land, her er jeg.
Can I ask you a question?
Oh,
and I have this, just to keep a distance, yeah, you know? Safe distance. We need to follow Boris, yeah? Filmer du? Hello.
Who am I looking at?
Hey, hey. So yeah, her står jeg altså da med Duncan. Duncan?
It's Scottish.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
But you're from London?
No.
Where are you from?
Scotland.
So we have a Scot here.
I do, yeah, of course. Yeah.
I really love your jacket. That's very
Thank
yellow.
You. Thank you.
I'm
you're
wondering, because every Easter, especially Norway, I don't know about here, but everything becomes so yellow.
Yeah.
Like, when you decorate with yellow.
We.
Why do you think that?
Yeah, there are some... Daffodils.
Yeah, they're everywhere.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You see a lot of fluffy yellow chicks as well.
Yeah.
Yeah. And golden eggs as
so
well.
So that's why you think yellow yeah, I reckon is such so. A...
And you know, and spring, it's when spring
yeah.
explodes, right?
Yeah.
The sun starts shining.
The sun starts shining.
Yeah.
I think you answered it. What's your favorite color?
Yellow.
Of course. In the Easter, everything becomes yellow. Is
really?
It the same in Spain? Like you use the color yellow a lot?
Not really. We don't have a color or something. We just
yeah.
Easter. Maybe it's because of the cheeks.
The
cheek end.
Yeah.
The small cheek end. It's quite.
Okay.
You know.
The chickens, and because we the egg.
Yeah, it's
usually
wrapped.
Like, do you know why the egg is such a symbol in Easter?
I don't really know. I don't know if it's in Norway, but here is like so popular, the eggs and the
yeah.
cheeks, like
yeah.
hiding them around.
I really love your hat.
Thank you very much.
Would you trade it with me?
So that you're all yellow?
Like, I will not make you trade my hat. Why do you think everything is so yellow?
I don't know, because of the commercialization of it with like daffodils and chicks and whatnot.
Yeah.
Yeah, I don't really know.
Yeah. Hi, Tom. I just have one question.
Yeah.
What came first, the chicken or the egg?
The chicken.
The chicken?
Yeah.
Why do you think that?
I don't know. Just, I guess it did, right? Where would an egg have come from, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay, that's all. Thank you.
Okay, thanks.
Well, you can't answer that question, can you?
You could try.
I'm going to say the chicken.
Yeah. Why do you think that? You don't know.
It forms and the shell forms around it, though, doesn't it?
So the chicken forms and then the shell forms around it. So the chicken came first and the shell within which it was encapsulated in, which is the subject of the question, then came second.
Have you been studying philosophy?
No.
Okay. You think the chicken came first?
Yeah.
Why?
Because who's going to have the better egg?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. There's no... The egg cannot, come from nowhere.
But where did the chicken come from then?
The creator.
The creator?
Yeah, God.
Oh, God, yeah. The creator, of course.
It's the same as Adam.
Yeah?
Yeah?
Adam, yeah. So who came first, Adam or Eve?
Adam.
Yeah. Yeah, it's written, so yeah.
So, you are an egg, right? Can you tell me what came first, the hen or the egg?
That's very interesting. Yeah. Thank you so much. Thank you. Da fikk vi svar på
the chicken.
Yeah.
I don't
what about
know.
You?
Maybe the egg.
Maybe the egg. Oh. So, do you have any traditions with food?
Hot cross buns.
Hot cross buns?
Yeah.
What's that?
It's like a bread type thing with raisins in it. Also Easter eggs, chocolate Easter eggs.
Yeah.
Yeah, I think that's about it.
Hot cross buns.
They're not very nice. Oh, don't like them.
What about in France? Do you have any food traditions?
We have Easter eggs.
Yeah.
Mostly. But I think I think they take this opportunity for family gatherings. But there is no really typical food that's going to be enjoyed there.
Where are you from?
I'm from Eritrea. Chicken sauce, traditional. It's called dorho. Tzabhi dorho. It means sauce of chicken.
Sauce
but
of chicken.
So chili is very hot and sweet as well.
So Easter is just the chicken.
Yeah, chicken that's the main dish. But you could do with a lot of different things.
Yeah.
Probably a roast lamb.
Oh yeah.
Often around Easter.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
You know, because you see them frolicking in the fields, so obviously you want to eat them.
You think.
Yeah.
With lots of chocolate.
Yeah, chocolate.
Yeah.
We paint eggshells, certain colours, and then that's quite
fun. Are you from Sweden?
No. You've got extended Swedish family.
Oh,
so,
yeah.
What else do the Swedes do?
We do quite a lot. Easter's quite big in Sweden. What do they do?
But we're from
Norway,
though.
Why are we talking about
Sweden? You Scandies, you know, it's all the same, isn't it?
It's not, but... Oh, yeah, it's very similar. How do you celebrate Easter in Spain?
So, it depends on the part of Spain.
Yeah.
So, in the south, normally, it's more traditional. Because, like, more Catholic and more religious, normally. Mm. Like, you know, Andalusia.
Yeah.
That's, like, very strong. So, they normally, on, like, Sunday, you know, Easter Sunday.
Yeah. Next Sunday.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Just they go out into the church.
Yeah.
And they just have this stick. I don't know how is it called. You know, when Jesus... was going
You
know, I don't know, that palm.
Yeah.
You know, and so...
Because today is Palm Sunday, actually.
Oh, so it's this one.
Yeah.
This Sunday.
This Sunday.
It's called Domingo de Ramos. And they just get blessed by a priest. So they get this water and they just spread the water into that palm. So it's really interesting.
You have very specific, like, rituals
for
the family and...
Exactly. So that is very close by. family.
So where in Spain are you from?
From Barcelona, which is not really traditional, as I said. Yeah. Like in the south, it's really, really, they are really passionate about Jesus Christ.
So they make a ring, they go to church.
Yeah.
We celebrate Easter.
It's taken very seriously.
Yeah, but in Western, they are actually worshipping, what do you call it, Ishtar.
Ishtar?
Ishtar and her son. It's pagan, pagan religion, but they, what they do is they assign it to like Christianity. The people think it's Christian, but it's not.
Oh.
So what they do is when they show you a woman.
Yeah, but it's in the same time. It's in the same
place. Yeah, it's in the same time. But when they show you a woman and a son, it's actually Ishtar and her son, I think it's Nimrod.
That's so interesting.
Yeah, pagan religion or Babylonian religion. So research it, you'll find that to be. So basically, there is a parallel religion that is celebrated.
Why? Why do we celebrate Easter?
We celebrate Easter because it was when Jesus was reincarnated.
You need to talk a little louder.
We celebrate Easter because it was when Jesus, according to the Bible, was reincarnated. Which is a miracle in itself, Jack.
10 out of 10! Woo! Ja. Takk for meg, og takk til alle de som jeg har pratet med. Jeg har nå vært rundt her med Elva og fått pratet med en del forskjellige folk fra forskjellige steder i verden. Og jeg vil si, jeg vil konkludere med at påsken, den ikke så annerledes rundt omkring. Jeg har kanskje litt forskjellige mattradisjoner og sånt, men påsken er ganske lik overalt, ass. Det vil jeg si. Ja, takk for meg. Tilbake til studio i Sjømannskirken.
Ja, velkommen tilbake igjen i studio her. Jeg vil bare hoppe inn og si at jeg er litt uenig med meg selv. Påsken er, ja, det er mange ting som er ganske likt, men vi fikk jo noen fantastisk interessante svar fra både en eritreer og en jente fra den katolske spanske tradisjonen, så jeg vil ikke nødvendigvis si at påsken er så lik overalt. Innholdet er det samme, men tradisjonene kan være forskjellige. Da vil jeg til slutt bare takke for meg og denne lille stunden. Jeg kommer til å bidra med noen korte videoer i morgen og på onsdag, før vi da går inn i påskehelgen med skjærtorsdag, langfredag og påskeaften. Tusen takk for meg!
Do you know, like, have you ever heard of an Easter song?
No.
Never?
No, never.
So I think, any I don't song. Want to put you on the spot, but should we make a song right
yeah.
now?
Yeah, right okay? now.
So yes. it needs to be about Jesus, of course.
Jesus.
On the cross.
Chocolate.
Chocolate, yeah.
Yellow.
And eggs and chickens, okay? So, okay.
Come on, let's
get into it. Easter.
Jesus.
Chickens.
Chocolates and yellow.
Yellow, yellow.
Color, yellow.
Woo, it is Easter and we're in London and thank you.